everybody. Welcome to our first ever Nutty episode. We are here at Q Nuts at 439 Highland Avenue here with Beth Quinn, the amazing owner of this amazing store. And I'm excited to be here and welcome to Talking Business. And please tell me about Q Nuts.
So it's a business my husband and I started in 2000. And we originally were event roasters. So we go out and do like concert series. We had a license, a new report for the city, and we would roast outside. And we, our whole idea was to basically earn a third stream of income, but also teach our children how to work alongside of us. And so we did that for a while. And then as things happened, you know, my husband was actually laid off from his job. And we decided we needed to basically turn this into a full-time business. So we started experimenting with flavors and ingredients and then packaging, and we received a really good response on what we were putting out. We were really committed to doing nuts that were vegan, gluten, soy, dairy-free, natural ingredients, that kind of thing. And so we just wanted to experiment with different flavors and do things that you wouldn't normally see in a supermarket or a specialty food store.
It's amazing. How did you come to making nuts and these recipes?
Well, actually, that was kind of an accident. We used to go into Downtown Crossing, and, you know, you see the street carts there, and they're roasting nuts, and it always smelled so good to us. We'd always buy them, but it wouldn't be quite as tasty as it is, good as it smelled. So we decided we wanted to kind of do better than that. And so we just started roasting and playing around with it, and it was fun.
And when did you start up in Somerville?
We've been here for about 6 or 7 years. And we originally were just looking in the Boston area for real estate, a small shop. We wanted to open a storefront and basically have a small kitchen where we could experiment and kind of roast and people come in and taste fresh products rather than just package stuff. And essentially, we just happened to come upon this store, and it's an awesome spot to be in.
So I'm so amazed with the store because there's so many products. And tell me more about what you have here.
So we wanted to obviously feature what we do, and you know, constantly evolving in terms of numbers. We have way too many flavors, I feel, at one time, but it's good. The public really gets into that. But I also wanted to feature other local food businesses. There's a lot of, it's a really strong food community here in Boston. So I have Christina's Ice Cream that the neighborhood people come in for. You know, I feature Effie's out of Hyde Park and McRae's Caramels out of Hyde Park and so on and so forth. Taza Chocolate, obviously we partner with them and use all of their chocolate in our chocolate flavors, which is really great. So we try to partner with people as much as we can. Boston Honey is another food company that we carry. And I think it's those partnerships are things that, you know, we help support each other. And people really are into local. So we hit that food market at the right time, I think, where people wanted to buy small and buy local. They know what they're getting. They know the passion that it's produced with. And I think it's a good thing to be a part of.
That's amazing. Everything here is made by you and your husband.
Yeah, we have people that work for us at Roast. It's basically family, though. My nephew is our head production person. Our son works for us. And the other employees that we have are adopted kids, as far as we're concerned. So it's kind of nice. It's a small, intimate group. So I think that you know, after our relationship with local business here, we went into the Boston Public Market and opened our second retail location. And there we have a whole new group of people to partner with. And that's really its own little community, which is really, really great. It's given us a lot of exposure, and it's brought people from there to here. They'll come out to Somerville to see, you know, kind of where it all started.
That's amazing. I mean, there's fresh nuts you can get. There are amazing gifts that you can get to other people in addition to, I mean, ice cream. I mean, to think that this business started is just as another activity, and then it ballooned up because you also supply to other restaurants and other wholesalers, correct?
We do, yeah. We wholesale across the country, mostly small specialty stores, but we've gotten a couple of pretty good accounts, big accounts, and so we're trying to, it's an interesting thing to try to go from just kind of supplying a local population to trying to up your production to a much larger endeavor. And that's something that is a learning curve definitely for us, you know. But we're getting there.
You're doing amazing. And how about with, is nuts, are nuts seasonal? Do they get more popular like at this time of the year being our fall episode? Or what do you think?
Well, you know, I think people have that in their head that it is. And certainly, you know, Thanksgiving through Christmas, we're insanely busy and people buy nuts as gifts and so forth. But with the advent of diets like Mediterranean diet and paleo and keto, I think people are really into using nuts as an everyday staple in their pantries. So yeah, they've become a lot more popular. Harvard did a health study and said that nuts are extremely healthy. So I think that that also got people on board to eating them more and incorporating them more in their diet.
Thanks to you that you make them so amazing and homemade. Let's gonna check out some of these amazing flavors because there's so much here. If you haven't been here, you have to. Right here in Highland Ave outside of Davis. Let's go check out some nuts. Okay, tell me some of these amazing nuts.
Sure. So we do everything from a traditional Bavarian style nut, which is our original sweet roast. That one is probably the only recipe that's not original to us. We go into a line of chocolates that are made with local Taza, 80% dark chocolate, with added ingredients like fresh lavender or fresh coconut or dehydrated raspberry. We do a lot of other flavors that are inspired by recipes like our Bananas Foster or our Coquito, which is a coconut rum,
yummy,
which is a traditional Puerto Rican cocktail.
Yes.
We do a line of spicy, we do a line of savory, and then in both stores, our cases are constantly rotating out with flavors that we don't necessarily package, but that we kind of, we like to rotate and experiment with different things. But everything we do is, again, vegan, gluten, soy, and dairy-free. So people are really into that. They know what they're getting. We use organic raw sugar in all of our sweet nuts and natural sea salt and 100% olive oil. And so the ingredients are very pure and simple.
How many different nuts do you sell at Q's Nuts?
Well, we work with probably four or five varieties, but in terms of flavors, we have probably 25 to 30 in production, and then we also make granolas, nut butters, fruit nut bars, so anything nut related.
That's perfect. So from Boston to the home here in Somerville, but also online, you can also tell us how you can order Q's Nuts on the web.
So if you go to www.qsnuts.com, you'll find us there.
And what type of goods and products do they have at the website, for example?
Pretty much anything that we package. You can buy gifts online. We do baskets and things like that. So,
now, you also mentioned you have other types of nuts as well.
Butter. Yeah, we have nut butters and granolas, and we make a fruit and nut bar, too.
Yummy! Definitely Q's Nuts. Being in Somerville gets the benefit of amazing clientele. Could you tell me a little bit about our Somerville community?
Yeah, Somerville's awesome because I'm really glad we ended up here because there's such a support from the local community. You have a lot of adventurous palates out there and people really into things that are new and different. So I feel really supported in terms of my customer base. There are people that have lived here for years, and it's the new student population. So every fall, there's a new crop of faces that come into the store, which is nice.
And also with the development and growth here in Somerville, that's also even more families coming into the store as well.
Absolutely, definitely. And I think that the number of food businesses has grown a lot since we first started here 7 years ago. So that's kind of nice, too, that there's a community of other food entrepreneurs that we can connect with, you know.
I mean, that's one of the reasons Somerville's so special. I mean, the family business, how you guys started here to have a whole storefront expand in Boston. What a blessing we are to have you are here in our city.
We're blessed too. You know, thank you for your support. We really appreciate it.
Thank you. Thank you for all these nuts. This is Nutty, the Nutty episode for Talking Business. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Everybody, we have such a great surprise because walking down Highland Ave, number 199C, right outside of nearby the Armory, you'll see 789 Bakery. And it's such a treat because it's a small business and here, right here in Somerville. And I'm here with its amazing owner. Please tell me your name.
Hi, I'm Sarah Chester.
Sarah Chester, yep. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Welcome to Somerville.
Thanks.
How long have you been here?
We have been here for 3.5 years, but we were doing farmers markets here before that.
Amazing. And what have you been featuring in farmers markets to the storefront now?
Cheesecake. That's our specialty.
That's awesome. What type of cheesecake?
We do a lot of different types, 30-something different types. But we've been named Boston's Best Cheesecake by CBS, so we're pretty honored.
That's amazing. How amazing. And how did you start this business?
Oh, good question. I always knew I wanted to own my own business, wasn't sure what it was going to be, and then I was experimenting with my cheesecake recipe and giving away an awful lot of cheesecake in the meantime. And so people started asking me if they could buy it, so I started selling under the table, and that was many years ago, and then it quickly became like I had 2 full-time jobs. So I left the one that paid me, and then I went to do this. Yeah.
That's amazing. And how long ago was that?
Good question. I think like 8 years ago, maybe.
Oh, my God. Yeah. How exciting.
Yeah.
Oh, my. And what advice would you have to our viewers in Talking Business who want to start a new business? Just like, what did you do?
Do a lot of research. Talk to a lot of people in the industry and start small if you're able to. It's really expensive to get into business. So anywhere that you can start small, it's very advisable. And get yourself a mentor. Yeah.
Amazing. And then how did you transition from farmers markets to a store in Somerville?
I'm trying to think. Was that a transition or was it a giant leap of faith? I did farmers markets for a while. I started off with just a couple, doing them in Cambridge and Somerville, and then expanded doing them in a lot of different cities around the area and towns around the area. I built a following, and then at one point it was like, do it or don't, you know? So I don't know if it was so much of a tradition as it was like, all right, we're going all in. And tried to find help with funding and then found a storefront, signed the lease, and I was in it.
That's awesome. And why did you choose Somerville?
I chose Somerville for its local economy. It's huge on the shop local, and I was involved with Somerville Local first. I saw the great work that they were doing. And then because I had been doing farmers markets, I already had a following in Somerville, and this was the place I wanted to be. You know, I knew I needed to target a niche market because it's a niche product, and people in Somerville support small businesses. So that was definitely my biggest factors.
Awesome. Tell me about your niche products. What makes 789 Bakery so amazing? I mean, it smells amazing. Tell us a little bit about it.
Yeah, so it's all about the cheesecake. Yeah. So we only do a small number of products, and we try to do them really well, but the focus is all on cheesecake. So we do little tiny mini cheesecakes. We do kind of a family size and then the big 9-inch. When you taste our cheesecake, you're going to taste that it's made with really high quality ingredients, but also it's not just in the flavor of the cheesecake, but in the texture. It's a light, fluffy, airy texture to it in a cake that's not overly sweet. So we surprise a lot of people with our cake. It's something you would find, you know, New York is considered the world hub of cheesecake, and it's something that you would easily find in New York.
But only in Somerville. That's
only
amazing.
Somerville.
Can you find 789 Bakery?
That's right.
Tell me about your flavors, like your favorite flavor and some of your most popular.
I always say start with classic. It's called classic for a reason. But we're about to have our second best-selling cheesecake come out. I'm actually leaving my shop in a couple hours to go over to a farm up in Lunenburg, Dick's Farm Stand, and they do they make our pumpkins. So we buy locally grown pumpkins. We don't do anything from a can or a jar. I puree them myself, which I will be doing over the coming nights, and we bake our own pumpkin cheesecake on a ginger snap pecan crust, and it sells like crazy.
Wow. What a treat. Oh my goodness. It's just so amazing. Tell me about some other flavors too.
Yeah, so one of my favorites is our mocha cheesecake. We also sell our cheesecakes as cheesecake popsicles, which we do frozen, and I love the mocha. Regular as well, but frozen, I just think it's phenomenal. We use Valrhona chocolate, which is consistently rated one of the top three chocolates in the world. And then Dean's Beans coffee, which is out of Western Mass. I brew fresh espresso, pour it directly into the batter right before it goes in the oven.
Wow.
It's phenomenal.
I can't wait to have one. This is so awesome. And how long have you been in Somerville now?
3.5 years. Yeah. Oh, we opened at Somerville Open Studios weekend 3.5 years ago.
That's great. That is so, so cool.
Yeah.
And wow. Guys, this is, if you have a dream and a talent, you follow through. And look, here in Somerville, we have a superstar. Thank you.
Thank you.
Do you have a website?
We do. 789bakery.com.
And can you order online?
You can. Yep.
Amazing. And my goodness, and anything else you want to tell our viewers?
Come and visit. We've got little tiny mini cheesecakes. You can buy them individually. You can get little variety 4-packs, but you got to come try it.
Yes. Thank you so much.
You rocked it.
Oh my God, that was fun.